say it wouldn't be a CES without Razer doing something crazy, impractical, or different. Now, this year they have Project Linda. And Project Linda is all about taking what they've done with the Razer phone and then bringing it, of course, into the mobile PC platform that they do so well. So what is Project Linda? What's the whole thing about? It's basically a concept that we've seen in Android for a while, but I think one that it looks like Razer's found a way to execute quite well. So they've taken the guts of and taking the guts and power of the Razer phone, which has a Snapdragon 835 processor, the awesome speakers, and you can dock it into this Razer Blade clamshell that's about 13.3 inches with a QHD display to give you, of course, the capabilities of working out of your phone like a true workstation. So what you have here is something that's really slick, well-designed, looks like a Razer Blade in terms of features. It's got a 200 gigabyte hard drive installed as well. You've got also got the ability to recharge your device and a much bigger battery. Now, in terms of speakers, it uses the speakers off your Razer phone, and we know the speakers are pretty loud and very, very good, so you have that built in, and your Razer phone becomes the trackpad for, of course, your new your Project Linda Razer book, I guess, Razer phone book, whatever the eventual name will be called. Now, the keyboard layout is pretty nice. It's got chroma keys, as you would expect from Razer. You also do have Android buttons at the very top, so you've got your home, your back, your multitask buttons, and the on-screen layout is also quite different. It's got a much more desktop feel, very easy to navigate. And this is something that Razer says that should help gamers if they want to push their gaming from mobile, the mobile Android experience, to a much more powerful desktop Android experience, if you will. You can use different applications, and I have to say they've really done a nice job in making it look really seamless and smooth. Now, of course, to dock and undock your Razer phone, you hit the undock button, and that basically retracts the USB Type-C port, and you can flip it out. The power button is also by the side of the Razer phone, and that's how you power your Project Linda device. So you hit the power button, and that actually turns it on. It's a nice concept, and it's something that is very interesting. It might not fit for everyone, but I think there is a market for you, and it's something that Razer will do quite well. Now, the other thing they also announced is the new Razer Mamba Hyperflux. Now, that's coming out, and that is something that's really interesting here. This is one of the lightest gaming mice on the market, and actually the lightest one from Razer. It doesn't have a built-in battery. It doesn't have a battery at all. It's a wireless mouse, and it comes with this Hyperflux pad, which constantly provides power to your mouse as you're using it. So you're not charging it all the time. It's just continually powered by the Hyperflux mat and, of course, the electrical field that it generates from there. It's a nice looking mouse if you've got all the Mamba features you expect. The Hyperflux pad has, of course, chroma lighting as well on there too. And in terms of height, or when you're moving, if you're one of those who moves your mice around as you game, you will not lose power because there is a certain level where the field connection will still work. Very interesting concept, you know, something different than we've seen on the market right now. And that might go hand in hand with your Project Linda device. But that will be priced at $249 when it actually comes out and available for launch. And I think it's something that a lot of people will find very, very interesting. So if you have any questions on Project Linda or the new Razer Mamba Hyperflux with the Hyperflux pad, let me know. I'll try and answer them for you. Otherwise, guys, thank you very much. Don't forget to like and share this video. Favorite this video. Check out all our other content on CES and stuff from Razer. This is Thunder E saying thank you, and always enjoy your entertainment.